and bank on it. You can put 100 grand on it. Anything I said, I stamp on it. In a private plane, I lamp on it. Lele order to call me bank on it. Cause I walk around with the bank on him. Show them Gangnam style, put the gang on him. Twist my fingers up on a bang on him. Lele ho, oh, lele ho, oh, yeah. Tobalo ako macho, yeah. Tobalo mako macho, yeah. Nobody know tomorrow. Choro ka choro. And if a boy feel macho, make him look red like a tomato. If him not dead, then he call matos. No go fambo. As that day comes, as I go, God watch over me, oh Lord. I cannot trust my
name.
Hi Bantase, welcome to a new vlog. If you are new here, hi, my name is Anish. I'm also known as Mrs. D. Please make sure that you subscribe, like the video. For my returning subscribers, hey Bantase, thank you so much for coming back. I really appreciate your support. So today is Saturday and we are at the beach. PE is hot today. It's very hot. So we decided to go to the beach, and then later on we're gonna have just a small braai with few friends, just to chill. I feel like today the water is very close to where we park the cars, because the beach we are at ilenduka ibane sandi eninzi. It's like a flat beach. So I feel like today the landing at the water is very close. I don't feel comfortable swimming. I don't feel comfortable for the kids to swim. They don't really like swimming. They only play with the sand. But I feel like I need to keep a closer eye on them. But I'm gonna show you. So yes, we are waiting for our friends. They're gonna come back here. Sana, I forgot to take off my slippers. I knew I was gonna forget to take off those shoes, and I did Kesana, and I did. So let me not be long. I will. Yes baby, yes, you want shoes?
Yeah.
Okay. Let me not be long. Yeah. I'll see you guys. I'll talk to you guys at home when we get home, when we are braaiing. Yes, Anna, let me leave these slippers here. I forgot to take them off. So let's go play with the kids.
We are here in Jimdana. Daisy.
Mm-hmm.
What is it?
It's C.
Superman,
yes.
Superman.
Is it Lulu Superman?
Yeah.
Okay.
Come, Lenny, then. Wait for Dad, then.
zimkile flops zam.
Eh?
Flops zam zimkile.
Yo, ninga kabi ndo zabantu emveni kweni.
Oh.
Oh wow!
It's so cool, uncle.
It's so cool, uncle. Oh.
Can you see me on the edge? I'm a lot. If they want what they would you find or would you try to get it? Tell me now about what you do be clear, yeah. Tell me now, I need you to be clear, yeah. I'm waiting for you, for you. I will wait for you. I will wait for you. Time on a rewind, yeah. Help me understand, can you tell me now why you made a war that was fighting now? And you fall and you run, can you see my big guns run around, run away as a rebel comes out? Can you call, call on me, can you call me? The pain and violence. Big truth, now it's big truth. I'm really right now from the side. Now call my name. Fall down when you see me. You know that I was there.
I wanted to cry, but I was too afraid to open, praying one day. day I find a piece of mind by the ocean. I spend all my time committing crimes to get closer. While at my nana house, I play the couch staring at a ceiling, trying not to get in my feelings, thinking of a way I can make these millions. Maybe that'll take this pain away and clear up all these rainy days. I've been broke so many times.
could blame it on the physical. I could blame it on your lips, your touch, your kiss. You know, real traditional. But your love's too original. You were anything but conventional. Baby, did you know that from the moment we fell in and knew we couldn't fall back, knew I'd always crawl back? Cause baby, it's the everything for me. For me, for me. Baby, it's the everything for me. For me, oh, for me. Cause baby, it's the everything for me. For me, for me. Baby, it's the everything.
Good morning. Hi, Bantase. I hope you guys are still good. So today is Monday. I just came back from dropping the kids to school. and Sana, another nail broke. And I'm not planning on doing nails anytime soon, Sana. But okay, another nail broke yesterday. So yesterday, I did vlog yesterday, just here and there. I woke up. Wait. So Saturday we had a braai, yeah? We had a braai and we had three of our friends. And then after that, Sana, we played games. Then they left around 12. Yes. They left around 12. We couldn't wash the dishes. So yesterday I woke up. I did some laundry. Because my helper was coming today. So I left some for her. I only did laundry for the kids' bedding, school bedding. And then after that, I washed the dishes. And I just chilled. So, yeah, today is Monday. And then I just came back from dropping them. I'm thinking of taking a walk or just a jog. Nah. But the thing is, I want to use my phone to listen to music, but it always gives me anxiety. To like go out with my phone, because guys, I've been robbed twice at gunpoint. Not here in PE, but not here, not in this area. I'm not sure if this area is that hectic, but I just get so much anxiety. And that, I think that's why I don't like jogging, because I want to listen to music. If I don't listen to music, I'm going to get bored and then I'm going to come back. But now I can't, because I'm always scared. I think Lentuka, being robbed leaves you with so much trauma. And you don't realize while it's happening that, guys, I am so scared. Because the first time I got robbed, I was with my husband. I think it was 2015. I'm just gonna give you guys just story, Anyana, because you guys love stories. But before I do, house rules, because Sana, we need house rules here. Please, guys, please do not skip the video. Do not skip and go to the part that you want, because it does show. For example, if I upload a vlog that is like 35 minutes long, the average watch hour is gonna be like 11 minutes, which means most people are not finishing the vlog, or they just skipping, or they playing it on times two. I don't know what is happening. I don't know. It's gonna be on 11, which means you are also skipping the ads, because you're not gonna watch the ads that you were supposed to watch if you were not skipping the vlog. So please watch, so that my vlogs can be recommended, and also so that I can like get paid a decent money. I'm gonna show how much I'm gonna get, because I haven't like received a payment yet, but I will receive it soon, because I just received my PIN. So I'm gonna receive the payment soon, and then I'm gonna tell you guys how much it is and what I'm gonna do with it. So yes, story time. Yeah, those are the house rules, né? Don't skip the video, don't play it on times two, don't skip the ads, please, I beg you. And also please like, so that it can be recommended to like a lot of people. Anyway, so this other time, I think it was 2015, I was working for this other company. If you stay here in PE, it's the Kuga, I think Kuga Development Center. But I was working for a company that Telkom resourced. That was outsourced by Telkom. I don't know. But we were working for Telkom, but under this company. Yeah, boom. So my shift was awkward. I think I was working until 9 o'clock at night, And then hubby was also working there as an IT support. But his shift was, the latest shift was 7 o'clock. So by 7 o'clock, he's out. Or by 6 o'clock, I can't remember. This was 2015. So he usually picked me up. He would come get me, walk and get me. Because we were staying in Kamvelihle, which is a township that is next to this place. But it is like divided by the wall, né? And then from the wall to the department or to the building, there's just a little bush, a corny bush that you walk on. I think it wamba payana for like 2 minutes and then you are there. And then kula wall, there was an auntie that would sit there because we were jumping to her house. So there was an auntie that would sit there with a ladder and then would pay her like 2 rand to go up the ladder and then jump to the other side. So hubby was like, "Ayen kaulela," and then while we were walking, we are in the bushes now, we are about to reach the wall, to climb the wall. And then these two guys come. And then, like, I have my bag and I have my arms folded like this because we're walking, we chilled, we like having a nice conversation. And then, magically, the other tall guy puts a gun on my head and he's like, "Imali bag, imali bag." Then did him na, "Imali bag, imali bag." "Imali bag, imali bag." The other short one has my husband and he has a knife on my husband's back. And my husband has his phone with him. But on my bag, I only had my lunchbox. I did not bring my phone because I had a tablet then. So I used to leave it, especially when I was working late. So I'm like, "Sana." Then I'm like, "Ina." He takes it and my husband wants to fight them. I'm like, "No, relax, guy. Hey, Sana." I'm like, "No, relax. It's okay." While they were walking, I'm like, "EM Dilo back." "EM Dilo back." And they're like, "Aba, yes, no one about buye, okay, but they were so scared. You could see that they were so scared, which made them very dangerous. Because abantu boyika, and then they have izikhali sana. It's not a good combo. So my husband is like, "Yeah, I'm Brazil. Don't. Dear, I can take these people." I'm like, "Sana, for a bag." "Sana, we need to go home. Let's go home. Because what am I going to say to your mother? Should anything happen, what am I going to say? You." So that was my first time being robbed at gunpoint. I'm not sure if it was a toy gun or kanyendoni. And the only time you will know mana a gun is not a toy gun is when it shoots. So I was like, "I'm not about to find out, son." Fine. Same year. I think this was 2016, early 2016. Same year. I was in Costin. So I got a call while I was still working for this company. I got a call to come do like assessments at Capitec Bank. They call me like, "You need to come do assessments. And then if you pass, you're going to do an interview same day." I'm like, "Okay, cool." I go. This Capitec Bank is the one that is opposite Livingston Hospital. I think it's Station Road. No, Stanford Road. Leanne, I'm not sure. So I go. So I have a bag. I have my phone. I just bought a phone. Ellen again in a contract. So I have this Samsung. I can't remember what Samsung it was, but it was a quite expensive phone. And I just took it. I think it had a week denial. And then I have my bag. I have my diploma, my BTEC, my grade 12 certificate, my driver's license, ID, and my CV. And I have like imali nje yokwela. Fine. I go to Capitec Bank, I write this assessment, I pass, I do an interview, and they're like, "Okay, you're now gonna wait for us to give you a call to place you in a branch." Like, okay, cool, happy time, happy news. there were these other two girls that did pass the assessment. So I was walking with them to go catch a taxi to town. So we are waiting, and then we see two ambulances rushing down, and then there was also a police car. So I tell them a story. I'm like, hey son, akutwa apa, people get robbed inside the taxi. Yabon. But in my mind, I'm thinking, while the taxi is by the robots or is waiting for someone to get in or someone is getting out, these people will come in like, give us phones, and then they take phones, then they go. That was my understanding of this whole thing. And then they're like, and I'm like, we need to be careful. When the car stops, we need to make sure that we hide our phones, okay? Like, okay, oh my god, I didn't know. Don't. I'm like, okay, fine. We get into the taxi. So we get into the taxi, and then the quantum had four boys sitting at the back. It's like four colored boys. Nobi age yabo is around 14-16 yabo. They're sitting there at the back, but you can see abandona, they smoke something or they drink something or they inhale something. Abeko clean yabo, but it's fine. Kuse taxi, the taxi was quite full. The only lenduka empty seat that was there, the empty seat that is in front of the back seat. So these boys are sitting a back seat. So tina sizohlala kule three seater ilapha phambi. So the girls go first, and then I sit by the, what do you call this, by the passageway to lean abantu bahamba kuyo. Then I sit there. I was meeting my cousin in town, who is also who was a policeman then. So I was meeting my cousin, like, to tell him what happened, like the interview, how did the interview go. And then I take out my phone. I'm about to tell my cousin Bana Jonga, I'm coming, I'm in a taxi, so I'll be there in like 10 minutes. The taxi is driving, and then there's ukukondi, I don't know about ukondi bizwa ntoni nge English, but taxi assistant, but the person that counts the money. So this guy gets out of the taxi. So the taxi just stopped. No one was getting in, no one was getting out, but it stopped. And then the kondi wapuma outside, but before imene, two of these kids, they stood up, and then while the taxi is driving, they like wabamba kule city that is in front of me, and lena is city am. So I was like pakati kuye yabo. So undivalelo hlobo, and I'm like, oh my god, something is about to happen here. I take my bag, I give it to the girl that was sitting next to the window, while I take my phone to hide it. I'm like, why am I hiding my phone? God would bodile lo mtat. So I take my phone, I tried to hide it, and then while I was hiding it under my lentuka, and panskwam ati lumdana angatet, he just pulled out a gun, pressed it here. Like, oh my god. And then gives me sandla, he grabs the phone, but then I'm grabbing it back because I'm thinking, man, there's so many people here, we can take this kid. Like, and then I start screaming, I'm like, ah! Sana, no one moved in that taxi, only the driver. He was like, and then open our jungle shop. No one moved. I'm like, ah! I'm grabbing my phone, this kid is grabbing this phone. And then the girl that I was with, the second one that is sitting in the middle, tried to help me, and then the gun was pointed at him. Hey guys, I am fighting for my life. And then I realized, Wanasana, no one is here to help me. I'm not getting helped. So I'm like, okay, let this kid go, because he is pushing this gun into my ribs. I'm like, oh my god, I'm about to die in a taxi. He is pushing, and I'm like, okay, let me just let this phone go. And it's not insured yet. Oh, guys, it was not insured. Waithatha la mntana ifoni waphuma. Ukondi all this time, guys. Ukondi akezi. Kondi is outside. I don't know where. Uthe xa bephuma abantwana, Kondi wangena phakathi, closed the door, yahamba imoto sana. So I'm not sure if it was an inside job okanye kwenzeka ntoni. And then the other two kids bohlika kwi-stop esilandelayo. And like zange registerishe ngokuyana yenzekayo. It didn't register. I was like, what happened? Like, did that happen? Kwenzeke ntoni? And why kuthathwe mna qha? Why kuthathwe yam qha iphone? Because abantwana banazo ifowuni. I was so annoyed and angry, and I was shouting at the driver. Oh, and after bohlikile ababesibini, omnye mama was like, Danam, do not ever do that again. Don't ever do that again. I'm like, kaloku mama, I thought you guys are gonna help me. She's like, for Nini, did you see the ambulances that were rushing down? Like, yes, Uti, these kids just shot someone. Like, what? Then why is it taxi? Uti, they shot someone and then they got into this taxi. So don't do that again. I'm like, damn. So that is where the trauma comes from, Gisana. That is where the trauma comes from. I used to get so scared if I'm in a taxi. I used to get so scared and paranoid, guys. Oh, parke. Please be safe, sana. Yo, sana. And again, ngoku aba bantu ba rob and ngemoto ngoku. So even if a kobantu baninzi bahambayo, there can be a car that would just stop and then rob you. So I think I'm gonna wake my husband up and ask him to accompany me for your walk if he does not have an early meeting, because the time is now 9:20. So I'll ask him to like accompany me for a walk, because I get so scared honestly. But anyway, thank you so much for being here. Thank you for watching up until this part. What else did I want to say? I don't know. Oh, thank you for guys, thank you for always watching my vlogs. See, oh my god, the vlog that I uploaded on Saturday is sitting on 1.2k views. It was on 1k views like in a less than 24 hours. It had 1k views. Thank you so much for watching my vlogs, and also to the notification gang gang. Thank you. Thank you so much, my people. I really appreciate you guys. there are things that are exciting that are coming. The pace is not gonna be like fast, but zikhona izinto that are definitely coming. So yes, I did a little vlogging, guys, endlini. I realized that I don't vlog a lot inside the house because the son and my kids and my phone. I'm gonna show you. The next clip is me showing you how many takes I took with the intro. Sana, I'm gonna show you. Please watch the next clip. Otherwise, thank you so much. I really appreciate you. See you on the next one. Hi, Bantase. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, hi, my name is Anita. I'm also known as Mrs. D. Thank you so much for being here. Please make sure that you subscribe. I'm coming. Look, mommy's making a video. I'm coming. Go to Lulu. I'm gonna come now.
Come on.
I'm gonna come. Hey Bantase, hi, welcome back to another video. Go sit, Lula. Sit with Lula. Lula, sit with Lemmy. Go sit with Lemmy, please. Sana, hi, Talandian Zalevi. Hey Bantase, thank you so much.
Oh, yes,
You, Sandy's gonna put this rule log.
Script, explosive, forgot my lines.
I forgot my lines. Oh, well. Hi, Bantase. Welcome back to a new vlog. Welcome back to a new video. If you are new here, hi. My name is Anita, also known as Mrs. D. Thank you so much for being here. Please make sure that you subscribe. Please go sit. Please make sure you subscribe, like, and share the video. Today is a mess. Lemmy, can you please go sit down? Today is Saturday, and we are off to the beach.